Normally, an estimated 3.5 million truckers stitch together America's supply chain, a complex web from ports to warehouses to chain stores. But trucking does not pay enough to compensate for the long hours at the wheel across this vast country.
Being away from your family, and sometimes you don't know where exactly you're going, and the GPS can take you some crazy place. It didn't happen to me a couple times. I've been at the wrong place. I ended up in a college one time. So yeah, that's the only, but I don't get too nervous about it because I know what to do. But the hardest part is probably being away from your family most of the time.
The COVID-19 pandemic has compounded a range of factors which have contributed to a shortage of roughly 80,000 truck drivers, up from 61,000 in 2018. This drop in the number of drivers willing to wait around at inefficient ports to ferry goods and sometimes driving for 18 hours a day means the supply chain is fraying. Congestion at inefficient ports is part of the problem. Most port drivers are independent contractors paid by the load.
So you get paid by the load. Some people get paid by how many loads they do a day. You do one load and sit and don't get paid for sitting. You just get paid for that one little load.
And industry analysts say if issues are not sorted out, the situation will worsen.
There's many reasons why we have supply chain issues today, right? And they start in Asia and they go all the way through to, you know, Asian factories not producing as much as they were. Asian ports a little backed up. You get here, obviously our ports are backed up, and then you've got issue. And then of course the driver shortage as well as part of that. But at some point on this, from 80,000 to 160,000 over the next 10 years, if this doesn't change, at some point on that line, if we go down that trajectory, we're going to see these same issues of today, but solely because of the driver shortage.
Nirmal Ghosh, The Straits Times in Baltimore, Maryland.